So this is the oil I'm going to use to bleed my brakes. This is 0.4 to 50 ml. We hardly required 50 ml to bleed the brakes, so 250 ml is more than enough. This cost ₹100 approximately, and the link is in the description. Before you're going to bleed the oil, before you're going to bleed the brakes, make sure you do not shake the bottle, because if you shake it, the tiny air bubbles in here in the bottle will get mixed with the oil and you won't see it. So if by mistake you shake it, just let the bottle sit for a week before you use it. Before we bleed, we have to prepare the bike for the bleeding process. Remove the valve cap and insert the spanner 11 mm, and then just loose a little bit. Connect a clear plastic hose onto the bleeding valve. We are using the transparent one so we can visually inspect if there is any air bubble coming out of the system. You can find this hose in a hardware shop and then insert it in an empty bottle. Now we'll open the master cylinder. I prefer to keep this flat so we can visually inspect the oil. If it is not flat, you can move this up and down. Then using a good screwdriver bit, try to remove the screws. If it is too tight, then you can use a hammer to tap a little bit. Try not to damage the screw tip. I had to tap it to open it. And then I found it's totally rusted due to moisture. You can clean these screws using a wire brush and apply a little bit oil before tightening. Make sure the fluid does not spill over to the body, otherwise it will eat up the paint. This rubber diaphragm moves up and down to fill up the vacuum space. Brake fluid should be changed every 2 years, but mine got it to 3 years, and you can see the result. It's full of dirt and moisture. Instead of flushing this black fluid into the system, we are going to suck that out using a cloth. It will save us the time, and also the dirt will be get cleaned rather than pushing it into the system. I recommend to use the gloves because the brake fluid is going to peel off your skin, but do not worry, it will heal soon. It will not hurt. When you do this, make sure you do not press the brake lever, otherwise air will be pushed into the system and it will lengthen up the bleeding process. There was too much dirt underneath, and therefore I used the brush to clean it. After cleaning, fill the master cylinder with new oil. These are the bleeding steps. In the step 1, you need to press the brake lever and keep holding it. Now in the step 2, open the bleed valve. Step 3, close the bleed valve. And step 4, release the brake lever. Do not miss any of these steps, otherwise air will enter into the system. Now you can watch me doing this. Press and hold, open, close, release. Press, hold, open the valve, close the valve, and release the lever. Press, hold, open, close, release. What we are doing here is we are using the new oil to trace out the old oil. Also keep an eye on the master cylinder. If the oil level is low, fill it up. Repeat this process for 2-3 complete fills of the master cylinder, and that is sufficient. You can also try a different method. You can drain out the old oil first and then fill up the new oil. But that process will take too long time to take out all the air from the system. When I'm done with this, I try to fill the master cylinder just to the point where I can see a slight air bubble so I can visually see the oil level. There is one thing to consider when filling the oil, and that is do not overfill. This is because when your brake pads is fully worn out, the piston gets popped out completely, and when you try to push back the pistons, the piston won't go back because you have left no room in the master cylinder for the oil to go back. If your brake pads are almost new, then you don't have to worry about this. After this, put in the rubber diaphragm and then install the cover and the screws. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.